Today's how-to, how to prepress AI file. Here we have a little sample file. We want to use this artwork in an InDesign or QuarkXPress file later on. How can we best prepress this element which we use in a larger piece of artwork desktop publishing layout? We're going to show you that today in this quick tip. I did a quick Google search for prepress AI files. And what we see here is how to do that. This little helpful prepress training checklist is, once again, how to use elements within InDesign or Quark desktop publishing layouts. Well, we read about raster graphics and things like that. We read specifically what they ask for or recommend with Adobe Illustrator vector graphics for four-color process printing. What we read there is that there are some things, some preflight elements we should check for. The image should contain no spot color swatches, just processed CMYK color swatches. It is best to convert all text to outlines to avoid potential font problems, even though Flightcheck can help solve that, and it should be saved as an EPS file. And of course, later they recommend pre-flighting your InDesign or Quark file, and even recommend using Markzware's Flightcheck, which is of course very wise. But what many often forget about checking an Illustrator file is that the preflight process should begin at the start of the larger graphic arts workflow. This is where you can stop these problems. Make sure there's no CMYK color swatches, make sure this color spacing is CMYK, and their recommendation, and by the way, many printers ask for fonts to be outlined. And we'll show you how Flightcheck can, you know, help you avoid that one anyway. So the preflight process should not only happen here in Quark or InDesign, it should happen there as well, but it should also begin at the very beginning when you're in Illustrator or Photoshop working on elements that will go within your desktop publishing or DTP layout. So how can we check this file? Well, we can do it manually, or we can use Markzware's Flightcheck. Let's see how that works right now, real quick. All right, so here I am on my layout machine. I'm now the layout artist in InDesign CS6 or CS5.5, or actually I use CS5 still. But nonetheless, I use QuarkXPress 9 as well, and Quark 8. I got this Adobe Illustrator file in from our designer upstream. The first thing I want to do is check it out with Flightcheck to see if it meets our standards. I'm over-exaggerating this because obviously, as a layout artist, I would preferably, in most situations, want an EPS or a TIFF file and not the native Illustrator file. Some situations you might very well, particularly with InDesign. All right, so first thing I'll do is drop this native Illustrator file on Flightcheck. That's right, Flightcheck also checks Illustrator, Photoshop, and many other files in addition to InDesign and QuarkXPress. We get a full preflight. You see the eagle very quickly doing its work. And the first window we see is a Flightcheck results window. All right, let's have a closer look at this now. Let's take a closer look here at what Flightcheck tells us. We see here that we have a screen font missing. Maybe we should have created outlines out of that file on the other machine as a designer. And printer font missing. Yeah, all the fonts are missing basically, from screen to printer, everything. Corporate fonts, that's something not to worry about. That's cool in Flightcheck. You can add in fonts that you do not want used for licensing reasonings or for corporate reasons. You know, very cool little feature. Actually, just a warning. It's not really a problem. So, let's go take a closer look at the main screen and see what we have. This is the Flightcheck main screen where we get all details about that file we just pre-flight checked. What we can see right away is the color and the modeling of the color is in CMYK, exactly what the checklist asked for. We have fonts missing. So, one thing to know about Flightcheck, if we were back on the design machine, is we can also collect all fonts and images used within the file. Not only in InDesign or Quark, but also the Illustrator artwork or Photoshop file. If there's fonts and other elements used, we will collect them. So if the graphic designer would have done that in the first place, he or she could have sent the job with fonts. Of course, in Illustrator, you can create outlines out of fonts, and we have other videos on how to do that, which I'll link to. But in some cases, maybe you'll want to not create outlines because that Illustrator file needs to be edited. For instance, in the packaging workflows and workflows where the Illustrator file needs to be greatly worked on for creating banners and things like that, you might not want to outline the fonts but keep the native fonts in there. So Flightcheck, very handy for that as well. So there you see it. Flightcheck lets us see exactly that we meet the specifications required, as in that checklist we just looked at, and how to get this AI file ready for prepress. Very cool. Well, there you have it. There you can see how you can preflight the individual elements before you bring them into your layout, your desktop publishing layout application. It's important to have a quality assurance check, but not only at the end, but for each element, which is in the design workflow, which we just showed you how you can do that with Markzware's Flightcheck. Yeah, a little diagram which highlights the importance of preflight in this quality triangle. Preflight, generically speaking, whether with Flightcheck or with some other form of preflight built into a program or little utilities that are out there, Flightcheck is one of the tools which is the only tool which is standalone and so complete, and the founders of the preflight category, the patent holders on preflight. Now what you see here is from design, desktop publishing layout, prepress, plate, as you, if you still have that, or direct digitally to press. You know, you can take out some parts of this, but what you see is that if an error goes all the way to the press, you're talking potentially thousands of euros or dollars or pounds, whatever it might be, wasted. However, if you cache that same problem all the way back here at the design stage, when we're working in Adobe Illustrator, and if we can prepress that Illustrator file before we put it into the layout, and before we go to prepress department, and before we go to the press, we can save a lot of money. Because that one little or two little preflight problems in Illustrator will only cost us a small 10 minutes to correct. This is where the preflight should begin, and it should go out and continue throughout the entire process. This webpage, I'll provide a link to it, was provided by graphicdesignemployment.com. That's graphic-design-employment.com, and they have some great tips and tricks for graphic arts and printing and publishing in general. If you'd like to try Flightcheck for yourself on your Illustrator or Photoshop files, not to mention your layout files like Adobe InDesign and QuarkXPress, go over to markzware.com and click on the products, Flightcheck. There you'll get full details on Flightcheck, more instructional videos, and a 30-day free trial version you can download and try today. How to prepress AI file. David Dilling from Markzware, signing off.